Fractions are mathematical representations of numbers which fall between two or more whole numbers, which is like this. Suppose this is 1, this is 2. How do you represent 1.5? So, if you want to write 1.5, there's another way of doing it. It's 3/2. So, this becomes a fraction. In this lecture, we are going to cover fractions. We're also going to cover, you know, different types of fractions. So those people who are comfortable with the fractions theory, I'd suggest that they move on to the next lecture. And those who want to take a look at a lot of interesting stuff about fractions, stay tuned. Let's see. First up, we see some operations on fractions, okay? So addition, multiplication, subtraction, division, the four operations. If I say that A by B is a representation of a fraction, okay? A is an integer, B is an integer, but B cannot be 0, okay? Because if you have division by 0, the number is not defined. So B cannot be 0. So if A by B is my number and the other number is C by D, then A by B plus C by D, we all know, will be A into D plus C into B upon B into D. Okay? This is how you do the addition thing. So you have AD plus BC upon BD. How do you do the subtraction operation? You do it in a similar manner. You say AB minus BC upon BD is your answer. The division operation, let's see the multiplication one first. A by B into C by D is simply AC upon BD. Okay? And in the division operation, we just have to reverse the next fraction. That is A by B divided by C by D is equal to A by B into D by C, which is AD upon BC. Okay? So these are the basic fractional operations. Let's take a look at how fractions are used in questions. Most importantly, fractions are used in ratios and proportions. Okay? So when we say we have to divide 100 into, let's say, 3 people, or for the sake of convenience, let's say 4 people equally. So how do you do that? You divide it by 4 and you say everyone gets 25 units each, right? Now, this here, if I say instead of dividing it into 4 people, we're going to divide it into 2 people, but in the ratio of 3:2. What does this mean? It means that one of them gets 3/5 of 100. The other one gets 2/5 of 100. Okay, so if I have 100 rupees, then, and I have to divide them in the ratio of 3:2 between 2 people, then I will divide them in 3/5 and 2/5 of 100. This becomes 60, this becomes 40. Okay? So these are questions that will come on ratios and proportions. The last thing, you know, the last important thing in fractions is mixed fractions. Let's take a look at mixed fractions. What are mixed fractions? And how do we solve questions based on them? Now, how do you represent something like this? When I want to say, let's divide 3/2, okay? Now, if we put it on a number line, okay, a number line is something like this. If I say this is 1, this is 2, this is minus 1 and so on. And if I say I have to represent 3 by 2 on this, we know 3 by 2 is 1.5, right? So it will lie somewhere here. That's your 3 by 2 or 1.5. Now what does 3 by 2 or 1.5 mean? It means that I have 1 plus 0.5 or 1 plus 1 by 2. When I have something like this, we represent them with mixed fractions like this. Okay, so 21, 1 by 2, 21, 3 by 4, 11, 1 by 3, or so on, are all mixed fractions. The only thing that you need to know about mixed fractions is that in examinations, when they use them, they'll be used as normal fractions, but they'll test you on how or what does the number actually mean. When you say, let's take a look at 21 1 by 2. When I say 21 1 by 2, what does it represent in fractional notation? This is a mixed fraction, let's have a pure fraction. So, the way that you're going to represent mixed fractions into pure fractions is, you'll multiply the denominator of the fractional part with the whole number part, which is 21 into 2. Okay, you multiply this part with this part and you add the numerator to the whole number, dividing it by the denominator. I'll give it to you the answer, but we'll do it again just for clarity's sake. This is 43 by 2, okay, in fractional notation. Again, let's take another one. If I say a simpler one, 3, 1 by 3. When 3, 1 by 3 is taken, how can this be represented? Now, when we do this one, we will multiply the decimal part with the denominator part and we will add the numerator part. How do we write this? We'll say this into this, which is 3 into 3 plus the numerator divided by the denominator. This comes out to be 9 plus 1, which is 10 by 3, the fractional representation. So you see, now you can apply all the mathematical operations on a mixed fraction by converting it into a normal fraction. Okay, this is what the examination will be testing you on. So I hope a lot of things about fractions will get clear, and do a lot of practice. Best of luck.